Morning, sir.
Good morning. Can I have your resume, please?
Yes, sir.
Shiva, can you tell about yourself, please?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir. My name is Shiva Kumar. I am from Nalgonda district. I am currently staying in Amirpet. I have completed my graduation MBSC in the year of 2022. And about my technical skills, sir, I am good at C language and Core Java. And my soft skills, sir, I am quick learner and self-motivated person. And my hobbies are listening to music and playing cricket. And my short-term goal is to get a job in a reputed company. And my long-term goal is to get a good position in our reputed company. So, thank you, sir.
So, Shiva, you said you like playing cricket.
Yes, sir.
Who is like your inspiration?
Virat Kohli, sir.
Why?
He is world's greatest batsman, sir.
Okay, fine. In your, so far, your self-introduction, you said you are aware of Java, right?
Yes, sir.
So, let's go with it. Can you able to tell the difference between JDK, JRE and the JVM?
Yes, sir. The JRE is an abbreviation for the Java Runtime Environment. The JVM is the abbreviation for the Java Virtual Machine. And the JDK is the abbreviation for the Java Development Toolkit that develops applications in Java. Along with JRE and JDK is also contains various development toolkits like Java Debugger, Java Document Compiler, etc.
Okay. Let's go with some more concepts. Can you tell what is polymorphism?
Polymorphism is nothing but poly means many. Morphism is forms degraded to exist in many forms is called polymorphism. In Java programming, a method or a variable or a object performs various tasks is called polymorphism. For example, a man behaves different kinds of variations. It's like that. So these are the two types. Static and compile-time polymorphism and runtime and dynamic polymorphism.
Okay, good. Let me continue in MOOC's concepts. So can you tell like what is encapsulation in Java?
Encapsulation is nothing but taking data into methods into single unit. It is called encapsulation. Atlas is best example for encapsulation.
Okay.
And the main advantage of encapsulation is that possible to use same name for the two different classes.
Okay, good to hear from that. Let's deviate from object-oriented programming language and let's go into interfaces. Can you tell the differences between interface and an abstract class method in Java?
Interface, abstract class. Interface supports multiple inheritance. Abstract class does not support multiple inheritance.
Okay.
Interface, it does not contain data members. Abstract class, it contains data members. Interface, it does not contain constructors. Abstract class, it contains constructors. And interface contains only incomplete methods. Abstract class contains both incomplete and complete methods.
Okay. Do you know anything about handle exceptions in Java?
Handle exception. Even if there is an error in the program, it is possible to handle it. This is called exception handling. You can handle the multiple exceptions using multiple cache blocks. A single try block without using of a cache block. And JVM executes a cache block only when there is an exception.
Okay. That's good to hear from you answer like that. Can you able to create and start a thread in Java?
First of all, we create a new thread and execute the code. In the run method of the myRunnable class, note that the run method of directly on the myRunnable class, instance will not create a new thread. You must call the start method on the object thread object to create a new thread of executable instance.
Good answer. Can you tell what is deadlock?
Deadlock occurs when the first process locks the same first first resource at the same time as the second process locks the second resource.
Okay.
The deadlock can be resolved by the cancellation and restarting the first process.
Okay. Let's go to some basic topic. Just tell about streams in Java.
Stream is simply nothing but it represents the flow of data. For example, a water pipe carries water from one place to another place. So similarly, the stream data also carries from one place to another place. This is called stream. A stream is not a data structure. Instead, it takes input from the collections, arrays, or Java input output collections.
Okay. Okay, that's good to hear from you. Okay, yeah, just tell how we handle input and output in Java.
Input. Java input and output is used to process the input and produce the output. The java.iolang package, IO package contains classes. All the classes are required from the input and output collections. And we can perform the file handling in Java or using the Java input output API documents.
Okay, good. Let me go with some operators. I feel, do you have an aware of equal to operator?
Yes, sir.
And you will be having an equal to method in Java.
Yes,
sir. So, can you tell the difference between this equal to operator and equal to method?
Yes, sir. Equals equals operator and equals equals method, the major difference between them, one is an operator, one is a method. Both these equals equals operator and equals method is used to compare the objects to mark equally.
Okay, that's good. Let me end my session with a program. Can you able to write a program for the addition of two matrices?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. So I'm going to discuss about addition of two matrices. First we have to take the class name. Class name is matrix. And I have to write the main method of the program. Public static void main of string args. And I have to write the integer values into rows equal to 2 and columns equal to 3 and initialize the integer values and set of first matrix, FM means first matrix, and I have to take the values 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. I have to take second matrix, set of second matrix 7, 8, 9 and 10, 11, 12, and next I have to write the object of the matrix sum equal to mu int of set of rows and columns. And after that I have to write condition of the program. For int I equal to 0, I less than rows, I plus plus. And I have to write another condition. For int j equal to 0, j less than columns, J plus plus. And after that I have to write the logic of the program. Sum of ij equal first matrix of ij plus second matrix of ij. And next print the system dot out dot println of, I want sum of two numbers, sum of two matrices. And next I have to write the another condition. For int set of rows least sum, and another condition is for int set of columns least row. And next I have to write the print the value system dot out dot print of columns. I have to close the So this is the program to find the addition of two matrices, and first we have to write the class name, and after that I have to write the main method of the program, public static void main and string access, and after that we have to take two integer values, rows and columns, and I have initialized the two integers, first matrix and second matrix. After that I have to write the new object, and next I write the condition. For int I equal to 0, I less than rows, I plus plus, and another condition is for int j equal to 0, j less than columns and j plus plus, and I have to write the logic of program, sum of ij equal to first matrix of ij plus second matrix of ij. Here it is the logic of the program, and I want sum of two matrices, addition of two matrices, sum of two matrices, and I have to write the two conditions and print the columns of plus equals and print the output.
Okay Shiva, can you tell the output of the program?
Yes sir. Here we have to take logic, first matrix plus second matrix. First matrix of first one is 1 and second matrix of first one is 4 equal to 5, and first matrix of second one is 2, second matrix of second one is 5, 2 plus 5 equal to 7, and same as well as 3 plus 6 equal to 9, and also second matrix of, we have to sum the 7 plus 9, 7 plus 10 equal to 17, and 8 plus 11 equal to 19, and 9 plus 12 equal to 20. This is the output of the paper.
Okay Shiva, good. Thank you sir.
Yes, thank you.
Okay Shiva, good with your technical stuff. How would you rate yourself?
I would like rate myself 8, because there is always a learning of scope of learning and improvement. Continuous learning is the most fundamental part of the learning and improvement skills.
Okay. Good Shiva. See Shiva, I had n number of candidates like you.
Yes.
Why I only hire you, not them?
Yes, sir, I have good communication skills, and you give me one chance. I prove myself and I never disappoint you. And I am also some intelligent for other candidates, because I know some technical skills also, and it improves the knowledge of my growth.
Okay Shiva, nice talking to you. My HR team will be contacting you. Hope we'll continue your journey.
Okay sir, thank you.